So do you have any tips for subbing in game? So this is at the play call menu. I'll go through offense games if you want to go through defense. So
sure.
Couple things I'll do. So this is basically how you sub players in. Number one, RB. Use RB, use the D-pad. You can cycle to any position and sub a guy in. Very easy. In mutt, sometimes I'll put in a pocket passer who's more accurate than my scrambler to throw in the red zone if I'm going to do high points. Sometimes I'll put in a trucking mac if I'm at the goal line, or a fullback, or I'll take a fullback out who's a blocking fullback and put in a big trucking back like a LeGarrette Blount. I'll put a taller receiver in on the outside. Jordy Nelson's already in, but say Cobb was in, I would press A, put Jordy Nelson in because I want to throw a high point in the end zone. I'll sometimes take out a slow receiver and put in a burner on the outside or on the slot if I think I have an advantage. So those are a couple different things that I'll do. Now you can use the right stick to get packages, and those are some options too. I just like to do RB. The thing about doing RB though is, like, say early in the game, you sub Aaron Rodgers out of this because you want to try and sneak in one read option with Brett Hundley. Boom. Well, Brett Hundley then stays in the game until you put Aaron Rodgers back in, or like backup.
You lose your ability to call the package.
Yeah, and then you can't go to the backup quarterback package if he's in there. So those are some things to note with the RB subs on offense. But yeah, basically, to get a mismatch, whether it's speed or height of receiver, a style of halfback, whether it's catching or trucking, and then quarterback potentially. Sometimes tight ends I'll mix up if I have a really good blocking tight end. Sometimes I'll put a tight end at receiver. So say Richard Rodgers was a really good blocker, I would sub him in there. And that's one thing I would do to get some advantages. Defensively, Gibbs, what do you like to do for RB subs?
It's virtually the same thing. So the example would be this, right? Like if I'm in 3-3-5 here, the way I would set this defense up, if I'm going to run a lot of cover two, I want to make sure that my middle linebacker in this case would be my best like coverage backer, because I need to drop him into deep coverage. So I wouldn't in this case want it to be Vontaze Burfict, right? So it's really about the position of the field, and it's about knowing your defense. So in this case, I know I want a user 59, whoever 59 is, it's Vigil. So I would then look at it and go, okay, who's the best user player?
Fastest, tallest, most agile.
Right. I'm probably gonna put Vontaze Burfict ISO by himself, because he's gonna have good. He's got good play recognition. He's good with awareness. Good player. And then I would user. If it's Ray was my best overall linebacker for coverage, I'd put him there. And then I'm gonna user. In this case, 59, I'm going to use her. Let's say it is Minter. Minter's the guy I want to use her, right? So that's how that would work from there. It's based on the formation, how I personally use it, yeah. And then who my user guys are, the way I want to run it, and then go from there. The next example off that is, now, I am running a lot of cover two right now. I'm also very aware of the 91 zone coverage meta that exists currently. I actually like 90 zone. I know people are saying 91, team 91, but that's okay. So what I do is I'm aware of that, and I say, okay, I play a ton of cover two zone. So what I now do is I take out Chris Harris, a starting corner, I put him at the deep safety, and I put Eric Weddle as my other deep safety. Okay, so now I have two really good zone coverage deep safeties. And then on the outside, I take out coverage players, and I put in big hit sticks. Right, I put in Steve Atwater. I put in a Rodney Harrison out there.
Must be nice to have Rodney Harrison.
I got Twitch Prime Legend. What? Twitch Prime Legend. So what I like about that, that's the way I will play. I adapt my defense for that. I'm not going to play a ton of man on this set. If I'm going to play man, I'd go to a quarter set, and I would make sure that I have all good man coverage guys out there.
One tip I would recommend when you're RB subbing guys in is to almost have like a checklist at the start of a game that you want to get to. What happens to me is, like, right now, at the start of the game, I'm on defense. I go to 3-3-5, and I'm able to change out all four corners into how I want them. The corners and the safeties, I can swap them in the 13 seconds I have when he picks his play. I can't do linebackers unless he doesn't pick a play quickly, but I can do linebackers on the second play of the game because I have enough time to switch the linebacker here to DN and then move a guy around. What I don't have enough time to do is then go to, like, dime and change guys, quarter change guys. So then it'll be like the end of the half, and I'll want to go to quarters to play man defense, and the strong safety's lined up on a guy, and I forget. So like you want to have a checklist of things you want to do. On third down, I should go to dime, even if I'm not going to call dime, but I should set my dime up, then go back to nickel. Same thing offensively, you know, I don't use this wing thing until I get down into the red zone, but like if I have time, why not set it up how I'm going to use it? And then, like I said, don't forget that you put in, you know, your trucking back for half to run halfback wham in the end zone, and now you're going to run a stretch, and now you got LeGarrette Blount with 82 speed running a stretch later in the game, especially when, like, you're now in the two-minute drill in the fourth quarter, and you don't really have time to RB sub. That's bad, because that's when you need it. Do it when you have the time. Take a timeout in the first half if you need to. Have a checklist. Okay, I need to change my nickel, change my dollar, and sub this in. Like, have a list of things you want to do.